Hello, my name is Mitchell Gross, and today we'll be talking about John Williams' piece entitled Adventures on Earth. This piece is a compilation of different cues that Williams wrote for Steven Spielberg's hit film E.T. The Extraterrestrial. This music was originally intended to accompany the bicycle chase near the end of the film, as well as the grand finale. However, Williams took these different cues and made them into a unified composition. But before we listen to this piece, we first need to designate the various themes and motifs that are used in this composition, as well as the form. The first theme of this composition is the adventure theme, which consists of both an A and B section. The heroic nature of this theme stems from the use of strong intervals like fourths and fifths along with the flat sixth scale degree. The harmonies also consist of major chords along with some added chord extension like the seventh degree. In addition, this theme is always played by the brass section, whether in octaves or in unison. While the A theme is repeated numerous times throughout the composition, we only hear the B section once in the beginning. This theme, along with the flying theme, ultimately unifies the whole composition. Now, the first motif we get is what I call the adventure motif. For those who don't know the difference between a motif and a motif is a short musical idea, while a theme is a musical statement. This motif complements the heroic nature of the adventure theme with its planning diatonic chords and its pedal tones. Furthermore, the motif has numerous compositional and orchestral variations that provide interest to the audience and help develop the piece. Here we have the government motif. This motif is used on screen in conjunction with the government, which is the main antagonist of the film. This theme is varied in numerous ways, however, it mostly consists of trumpets playing the first part of the phrase, while the woodwinds take over the second, with the harmonies consistent of chromatic median minor chords. The next and most infamous theme from this composition is the flying theme, which is used when Elliot and his friends fly over the moon. This theme consists of fifths, stepwise motion, and sequences between the tonic and the supertonic, implying a Lydian mode. Like the adventure theme, this theme has an A and B section, with the B section being only played once in this composition. This theme is mostly played by the strings, playing in four octaves and being strengthened by the woodwind section. Now we have the wonder motif. This motif is played by various instruments throughout the piece, but the most memorable rendition is at the end of the piece, where four horns are playing in unison. This motif is centered on the Lydian mode, with the melody highlighting both the sharp 4 and 2 scale degree. Williams uses this motif to compositionally solidify the second half of the piece, since there are numerous amounts of transitions and interlude material. The last theme is the wonder theme, which complements the wonder motif. Both are in the Lydian mode, however, this theme consists of large intervals like the major seventh and small intervals like major and minor seconds. This theme is the lengthiest theme, yet is the most simplest considering it only has quarter notes and dotted half notes. There is a B section that complements the A section, which has some chromatic enclosures as well as some modulations. Finally, the last motif is the separation motif. This is played during the end of the film when Elliot and E.T. say goodbye. This motif is technically two motifs in one, since both lines are counterpunctual to each other and are almost played with each other. It consists of high strings and mid-range woodwind lines, which captures a bitter yet sweet farewell. Most of the time, this motif stays within the major key. However, Williams utilizes some alterations like the flat sixth degree to portray a sense of melancholy. Now let's talk about the form. The form of this piece is ultimately in ternary form, consisting of an A section, a B section, and an A prime section. Even though there are some differences like tempos and new themes, the two A sections are both centered in the key of C, while the B section starts out in the key of C but travels to different keys. In addition, the adventure theme is played only in the A section of this piece, therefore it is safe to say that this piece is in ternary form. In the first A section, there are many thematic material like the adventure motif, the adventure theme, the government motif, the flying theme, and the wonder theme. In the B section, the thematic material consists of the wonder motif, the government motif, and the separation motif. It is duly noted that there are transitions and interludes in this section that add a lot to the piece. Finally, the A prime section consists of the adventure theme, the flying theme, the wonder motif, and the separation motif. Before we listen to the piece, it's important to pay attention to all the themes and their variations. These variations could be either compositional, orchestration-based, or even both. It is also important to pay attention to the transitions and interludes that connect themes and even add depth to the composition. And finally, it's important to know how the ABA form solidifies the whole composition. I just want to thank you for listening and hearing me talk about this piece. I hope you enjoy the rest of the video and I hope you have a good day.